In a 2000 Mathematical Intelligencer opinion piece, mathematician Granville Sewell compared the history of his partial differential equation solver to the history of life. He noted that there are large jumps in both, where major new features appear for the same reasons. Gradual development of the new organs or new systems of organs that gave rise to new orders, classes, and phyla would require the development of new but not yet useful features. So Darwinism could not explain the development of these new features even if they did occur gradually. And, according to the fossil record, they don't. Professor Sewell argued that it was inconceivable that sophisticated computer software could be designed by a programmer who, like natural selection, is unable to think ahead more than a few characters at a time. But the whole issue is much simpler than this, and at the end of the piece, he wrote the following. The biologist studies the details of natural history, and when he looks at the similarities between two species of butterflies, he is understandably reluctant to attribute the small differences to the supernatural, but the mathematician or physicist is likely to take the broader view. I imagine visiting the Earth when it was young, and returning now to find highways with automobiles on them, airports with jet airplanes, and tall buildings full of complicated equipment such as televisions, telephones, and computers. Then, I imagine the construction of a gigantic computer model which starts with the initial conditions on Earth 4 billion years ago and tries to simulate the effects that the four known forces of physics, the gravitational, electromagnetic, and strong and weak nuclear forces, would have on every atom and every subatomic particle on our planet, perhaps using random number generators to model quantum uncertainties. If we ran such a simulation out to the present day, would it predict that the basic forces of nature would reorganize the basic particles of nature into libraries full of encyclopedias, science texts, and novels, nuclear power plants, aircraft carriers with supersonic jets parked on deck, and computers connected to laser printers, CRTs, and keyboards? If we graphically displayed the positions of the atoms at the end of the simulation, would we find that cars and trucks had formed, or that supercomputers had arisen? Certainly we would not. And I do not believe that adding sunlight to the model would help much. Clearly, something extremely improbable has happened here on our planet with the origin and development of life, and especially with the development of human consciousness and creativity. Of course, constructing such a model is impossible, but Sewell thought imagining it was a useful exercise to get across the point that natural selection, the one unintelligent force in the universe widely credited with the ability to create spectacular order out of disorder, is not a real physical force, and so cannot be included in the simulation, and the point that unintelligent forces cannot explain human intelligence. Rice University chemist James Tour makes a similar point regarding the origin of life. He states, "Molecules don't care about life." Unfortunately, evolutionary biologists are not impressed by such simple arguments. They don't believe you can contribute anything important to the debate without looking at the details of their theories on the origin and evolution of life. They understandably don't believe you can conclude that a complex problem is unsolvable before examining every proposed solution. But mathematicians know that sometimes you can. Let's look at a very simple example. Here is an 8x8 array of squares. It takes 32 dominoes, each of which is a 2x1 rectangle, to exactly cover the 64 squares. If we remove the squares in the upper left and upper right corners, it is easy to exactly cover the remaining 62 squares with 31 dominoes, and there are a huge number of ways to do this, placing some dominoes horizontally and some vertically. This time, let's remove the upper left and lower right corner squares, and try to cover the remaining 62 squares again with 31 dominoes. But if you try, you will not succeed. You will probably end up with one domino remaining and two uncovered squares which are not contiguous. You can spend the rest of your life trying different arrangements of the 31 dominoes to exactly cover these 62 squares, but at some point, a mathematician will think, maybe it is possible to prove this problem has no solution. In fact, it is possible. And in this case, it is easy. Think of the 8x8 array as a chessboard and notice that no matter where you put a domino, horizontally or vertically, it will cover one white square and one black square. so dominoes will always cover the same number of white and black squares. But the original chessboard has 32 white and 32 black squares, and the upper left and lower right squares have the same color. So if you remove these two, you will not have the same number of white and black squares to cover. From this viewpoint, it is obvious that there is no solution. Mathematicians are trained to value simplicity. When they have a simple, clear argument and a long, complicated counterargument full of unverified points, they accept the simple argument, even before they find the errors in the complicated argument. They know the errors must exist, and if they look for them, they will eventually find them. The strongest argument for intelligent design is to clearly state what you must believe to not believe in intelligent design. Materialist scientists have been trying for a long time to explain everything that has happened on Earth without design. And they may in fact be able to explain everything that has happened on other planets without design. But to see that the problem they are trying to solve has no solution, you only need to take the broader view. Realizing that they are trying to explain how a few fundamental unintelligent forces of physics alone could have rearranged the fundamental particles of physics on Earth into computers, spaceships, and smartphones. And there is perhaps nothing in all of science that is more clear or more certain than that they could not have.